1-4, translating words into math. When solving real-world problems, you will need to translate words or verbal expressions into algebraic expressions. For example, in addition, you could use the words add, or plus, or sum, or more than, or increase by, all to represent the addition. For subtraction, you could say subtract, minus, the difference, less than, decreased by, take away, or just less. Let me take a minute and point out something here. Two different times we have seen the word than. Those thans are very important because notice what took place here. Three was in the front, it ended up in the back. 12 was in the front, it ended up in the back. Anytime you see the word than, you flop them. You flip-flop the order they're in. That's very important to remember. Because, while it wouldn't make a lot of difference in this problem, let's say x was equal to 20. Okay? Is 20 minus 12 the same thing as 12 minus 20? No, it's not. So you got to make sure if you see that word than that you flip-flop the order they're in. Under times, we've got times multiplied by and product. And then under divided by, or division, you've got divided into, divided by, and the quotient of. So we're going to take and write each phrase as an algebraic expression. Let's take and start off with the product of 20 and t. Under the product of 20 and t, how do you write that using math? Jacob Allen, how would you write that using math? There you go, 20 times t. Easy. Let's pick on another one here. Whenever the computer catches up to us. Oh. And of course, yes, we do need to circle that answer. Forgot about that. Always circle your answers. 20 less than a number. Sydney Wilson. 20 less than a number. All right, let's try Jordan Sykes, 20 less than a number. Ben Cribbs, what'd you come up with for an answer on that? 4 times parentheses, n plus 2. Let's see, it's got times, which means we're going to multiply. The computer's really having issues right now. It also asks for the sum, which means we're going to add. So what are we multiplying? What are we adding? We are, come on, computer. Multiplying 4 times, just like Ben said, n plus 2 inside parentheses. You got to find the sum of n and 2 first, and then multiply it times the 4. And, of course, you want to circle or box that answer. Let's try this one out. The sum of 4 times a number and 2. The sum of 4 times a number and 2. Try that one out. Cat, she's not with us today, so let's pick on Cora instead. Cora, what'd you come up with?
I came up with 4 plus
Nope, that one's not going to work. This is a toughie, though. This is a toughie. Let's see if Emily Schindler, what'd you come up with? Brian's got his hand up. What you got, Brian? M plus parentheses 4 times 2. The sum of 4 times the number. Not quite. Not quite. Yes, sir, what do you got? Getting closer. Nope, that's the same thing that Brian said. What you should have done, if you worked it out exactly the way it said, once again, you got a sum here, and you also have got multiplication, which when the computer catches up, we'll point out. You got times, which means to multiply. So you've got to find 4 times the number first, 4 times n, okay? John came real close. He said n times 4. But if you wrote it the way or worked it the way it was written, it should have been 4 times n, and then plus 2 after that. You got to find the 4 times the n first, and then find the sum of the 4n and the 2. And of course, you do want to circle or box that answer, making it easy to find. Questions? Jid reads p pages each day in a 200-page book. Write an algebraic expression for how many days it will take Jed, with only one J, to read the book. You need to separate the total number of pages into equal parts. Write it down. This, of course, will involve division. What you have here is a fraction. You've got the total number of pages of book divided by the number of pages read each day. If the book has 200 pages and you read p pages every day, that would be your equation for your expression for solving it. And you'd circle it and you're done. That's all there is to it. All right, that's all there is to it. Your assignment, page 24, 1 through 29 odd. Isn't it amazing that when God created this poison dart frog, they even put the skull and crossbones on its back so everybody would know it was poisonous? That's pretty cool stuff. Is that real? Of course it's real. You don't think that they would make them like that in nature so that everybody would know they're dangerous? Yeah.